Another beautiful start. Temperatures out there in the 60s again this morning for a large part of the Brazos Valley, 67 degrees in Bryan College Station. Take a look at this. Fairfield, 63 degrees. Our average low, 74. So the dry air continuing to allow those temperatures to cool off efficiently at night. But we're starting to see an uptick in the moisture. Notice the winds have flipped back around toward the south and the east. And that's really creating an uptick in the temperatures as well as those heat indices. 96 degrees in Bryan College Station, 100 in Gidding, so it's a little bit toasty out there. The average high, 96 degrees, 101 in San Angelo. Take a look at this, 103 in Del Rio, 93 degrees at this hour in Amarillo. Warm front draped across the Brazos Valley. Some showers and storms developing along this, working their way toward coastal parts of Texas, but also notice some showers and storms in southern parts of Oklahoma. This is a little upper-level disturbance, and this upper-level disturbance is going to track toward the southeast as we head in the overnight hours. That's going to trigger a complex of showers and storms that may impact the western Brazos Valley tomorrow morning between 6 to 8 a.m. So generally going to be to the west of Bryan College Station. Rockdale, Caldwell, Giddings have the best opportunity to see some showers and storms as we head into the early morning hours. This is quickly going to die off, but once those temperatures climb up into the 90s, some isolated storms going to bubble up out there, especially toward that I-45 corridor. Western zone looking like it's going to remain dry during the afternoon hours. And a similar setup as we head into Sunday. We're going to notice that we see those temperatures start to increase heading into the morning hours, and we get that atmosphere just a little bit juicy and unstable. Isolated storms developing near I-45, working their way off toward the south and the west. Coverage only going to be about 20 to 30%, so most areas going to remain dry, but we do have isolated storm chances. Better storm chances arrive next week due to Tropical Depression 14. Hurricane hunters currently investigating this. There's been a nice blow up of convection with this system over the past few hours that has sustained itself, so it looks like it's likely going to develop into Tropical Storm Marco over the next few hours, gradually working off toward the north and the west, impacting the Yucatan Peninsula as we head into the weekend, and then emerging in the southern Gulf of Mexico and continuing that northwesterly track, going to be just off of the Texas coast as we head into late Tuesday as a strong tropical storm, possibly a hurricane, and then it's going to work its way toward the north and the west, tracking toward the Brazos Valley. So we're going to see some impacts here. There's still quite a bit of uncertainty, though, so keep in mind that this cone extends from near Brownsville all the way into southeastern parts of Louisiana. Take a look at the spaghetti plot. So each one of these lines represents a model run indicating where that model thinks this system is going to track, and you can see it's all over the place from Mexico all the way in to Louisiana, so kind of all over the place, but there is a general cluster as you get off of the coast of the upper Texas coast. You can kind of see several model runs in this area, so that's why the National Hurricane Center is indicating the system is going to track just toward the Galveston area, maybe a little to the southwest, making landfall and then eventually impacting central parts of Texas, including the Brazos Valley, but continue to check back because there's still a lot of uncertainty, and it's possible that this may shift a little bit farther toward the south or maybe a little farther north over the next few days. There are some questions about the intensity as well, but we do have some favorable factors that could help boost up this intensity. So don't just look at, oh, tropical storm. It could be a hurricane as it makes landfall late Tuesday. Temperatures are in the upper 80s across central parts of the Gulf of Mexico. This water is kind of like the fuel for the tropical system, so there's going to be adequate fuel out there for Marco as it works its way into the Gulf of Mexico. And the shear is going to be relatively minimal as this system continues to track toward the north and the west. You can see there's no shear over central parts of the Gulf of Mexico heading into Monday. A little bit of shear off of the Texas coast as we head into Monday. So this may interfere just a touch with some of the convection, but the shear, again, is toward the north and the west of the storm. So this should be able to develop into a hurricane and possibly sustain that strength as it approaches the Texas coast. We'll see what this shear does on Tuesday across central parts of Texas, extending into the upper Texas coast. But right now, it does look favorable for a gradual intensification as we head throughout the weekend into early next week. Growing concerns for impacts here in the Brazos Valley. High uncertainty with the strength and forecast of course, like we just talked about, but you want to keep checking back several times a day for these updates on the system, as it's a very fluid forecast. We're expecting to see some heavy rain across the Brazos Valley, looking like a low flood threat, though gusty winds a possibility and a low chance for tornadoes here in the Brazos Valley. Minimal rain throughout the weekend, but as we head into next week, we start to see an uptick in the precipitation chances, 2 to 6 inches a possibility for the eastern and southern zone, 1 to 2 inches for the western zone. Keep in mind, this may need to be shifted a little farther west or a little farther east, just depending on that exact track of Marcos. So a highly fluid forecast, and we're going to see some strong winds as well, especially from the mid to upper Texas coast. A high likelihood of seeing tropical storm force winds, about a 30 to 40% chance for our southeastern zone, a 20 to 30% chance of seeing those tropical storm force winds here in central parts of the Brazos Valley. That would be 39 miles per hour or stronger. We're also keeping an eye on Laura. This is going to impact southern parts of Florida as we head into the weekend early next week, possibly tracking up toward New Orleans by the middle of next week. So a lot of tropical stuff going on up there, Tristan. We are going to see our impacts here, a pretty good chance of rain as we head into late Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and early Thursday morning. So a lot going on in the weather department.
So what kind of precautions would you give people for this weekend? What should they go out and do this weekend to make sure they're ready?
This weekend, I would go ahead and put up your lawn furniture, your trash cans, all that stuff. You want to secure it because there could be some gusty winds. And of course, that's going to be the main thing here, the gusty winds and the heavy rainfall. But it doesn't hurt to, if you have a generator, get some gas, some stuff like that in case a tree were to come down and knock down a power line. But really just kind of secure all the loose items in your yard.
All right. Thank you so much, Chris. Sports is up next.